It is your turn. It is your move. Go take.
Last season seemed like a relative disaster going 8-5, but there was just one fewer win in a rebuilding season than there was in the Johnny Manziel-led 2013 campaign. Even so, it wasn't really fun 2014 season. So here's the deal with the 2015 Texas A&M Aggies. Quarterback Kyle Allen showed what he could do against West Virginia, and he seemingly solidified himself as the star of the program for the next several years now that Kenny Hill has transferred. Maybe. Super recruit quarterback Kyler Murray might have something to say about that, and he might take over the starting quarterback gig at some point. The weapons are there at running back, and the receiving corps is going to be devastating with Speedy Noyle and Ricky Seals-Jones, just two of the big-time stars. However, the defense not only has to be far better, but has to improve without three of its top four tacklers. However, three starters are back up front, led by pass-rushing terror Myles Garrett. It all has to translate into more production on defense. The Aggies finished 102nd in the nation in total D, and while not rocking on that side of the ball didn't matter so much back when Mr. Football was doing his thing, the defense has to show up more on a consistent basis this season and going forward. Now, it's still going to be tough, though, for A&M to do much more, even though it should be stronger on both sides of the ball. Starting out against Arizona State's going to be tough, and getting South Carolina, Alabama at home will help. However, road dates at Arkansas, Ole Miss, and LSU are going to be really nasty. So another 8-win season will probably be the ceiling. I'm Pete Futak. To dive deeper into the 2015 Aggies, check out the written preview on Campus Insiders.